Titan Season 3's stoner version of the Scarecrow can be incredibly silly at times, but it still works to an extent. The Scarecrow is inarguably one of Batman's most famous villains. When he is introduced in Season 3 of the HBO Max series, he is already locked up, his days of scheming and toying with the citizens of Gotham City long over. However, the series provides a fresh take on the classic villain by turning him into a stoner. When Dick Grayson, aka Nightwing, returns to Gotham City following Jason Todd's death, it isn't exactly in the same place as when he left. Alfred is gone, Barbara Gordon is police commissioner in her father's place, and Bruce Wayne, his mentor, father figure, and the vigilante known as Batman, is a shell of the man he once was. Titans has embraced being an adaptation of the characters from the comics, so it should come as no surprise that Scarecrow, whose real name is Jonathan Crane, is a stoner who is locked up in Arkham Asylum in this iteration. Now working as a police consultant in their bid to stop major criminals in the city, which once included the Joker, Dick is shocked to learn the Scarecrow aids Commissioner Gordon's team in exchange for marijuana. Sometimes, Scarecrow's stoner demeanor comes off as an act and can be incredibly ridiculous, especially considering the character's comics history. Scarecrow's actions, from his discussions with Dick to his escape attempt, are awkward and oftentimes very foolish. Despite how nonsensical it all may seem, however, Scarecrow being a stoner also works. It's a surprising change from previous portrayals of the character and it allows him to maintain the cloak of mystery. He's also still a sinister, if oddball, person. It's something being a stoner doesn't fully mask, while also allowing the Scarecrow to be multi-layered. He's calm, but also eerie, and it's because of his predicament and stoner persona in Titans that viewers get to see him in a different, interesting new light. It also makes sense considering the series' appeal to a younger demographic. Even the characters, most of whom are adults, are still the next generation of superheroes after Batman, and Scarecrow being a stoner certainly leans in that direction. The fact that he requests marijuana in exchange for his expertise in psychologically profiling criminals is certainly unique to Titans. In the comics, the villain is typically portrayed as a genius and former psychology professor whose experimentation with lethal toxins and other chemicals led him to develop his signature serum, one that dredged up his victims' worst fears and exploited their deepest terrors for research. Unlike other villains, the Scarecrow wasn't after notoriety, attention, or money. For the most part, he retains these characteristics in the HBO Max show, while the addition of being a stoner arguably makes him seem more harmless than he's typically made out to be in other media. In Titans, Scarecrow is still not to be trusted, but there's more time spent with him as a person because he's simultaneously locked up and high. It makes for a rather intriguing dynamic between him and Nightwing, too, one that likely wouldn't have been the same if Scarecrow wasn't smoking cannabis so often.